Hi, hello, welcome to Unacademy. So, in this particular session, we will be discussing, we will be revising the chapter live process in a small sessions, okay? So, we had discussed about this particular chapter maybe with the 10 or 11 lectures. But in this particular series, I will be finishing off the chapter in 3 to 4 sessions. So, before starting the revision, what you have to do? Yes, if you haven't connected me, you can connect me quickly. So first you have to download Telegram app and then type the URL tinyurl.com/foundationchat. So by typing this URL, you will be able to join to the group. So then you can ask questions directly in the group or personally as well. And I guess by now everybody knows the timetable, right? Everyday videos are getting premiered. The biology video will be premiered on Saturday and on Wednesday, and other subjects will be premiered every day. And coming to the main important thing is about Plus platform. So if you download an Academy Learning app, you will be able to find a great opportunity called as Plus option. So when you click the Plus option, if you have taken the subscription, you will be able to attend multiple live classes by multiple educators. So top educators of India from various parts of our country will be teaching you for various courses, not only for NTSC exams, but also for NSCGS, NSO, NSTSC, and also for the foundation of NEET and JEE. Various educators will be teaching you, and also not only for the science and mathematics, but also for social science and English subjects. The courses will be there, and there will be a separate test series, quizzes, weekly quiz, mega quiz, and also a separate doubt clearing session will be there soon after the 3 classes. Okay, and also while answering the quiz questions, you will be able to see your rank. So you will be becoming more competitive in your 8th, 9th and 10th standard. So which will be helpful for you in your 11th and 12th to crack various competitive exam. Okay. Yes. So already I have made various courses. So prior to this particular month, that is in the last month as well, I have made various courses for NTSC and also for the foundation of NEET. And in this month, I have already started the courses for NSCGS as well as NEET Foundation on the topic diseases. So in this particular course, I will be explaining you about in detail about anything associated with the diseases. It can be cancer, immunity, or various types of diseases. And also we will be having the separate batch courses for class 9th and 10th standard, and a separate course on figures and activities of life process. So in this particular course, I'll be extending this for the next month as well, since most of you are writing board exams. So I will be helping you out how to remember the labelings, how to draw the structures easily, and how to study the activities which has been given in your NCERT or the textbooks. Okay, so take the subscription as soon as possible. And more importantly, look at the way of the classes that is held in Plus platform. So students will be able to send their doubts and we will be able to solve immediately. And also you will be able to chat, you will be able to send the comments, questions, likes. Okay, so how to take the subscription? First you have to download an Academy Learning app. Okay, when you download an Academy Learning app, you will be able to see a screen like this. So go for Plus option. So when you click on Plus option, you will be able to see different goals. So if you are studying in class 9th and 10th as well as 8th standard, you can go for foundation and NTSC. If you are the one who are studying in class 11th and 12th, you can go for JEE or NEET or anything. So these all are the other goals. According to your wish, you can go for any of these goals. Okay, so when you click on foundation and NTSC, you will be able to see an option like this. So click on get subscription. When you click on get subscription, you will be able to see different month subscription. So 1 year and 2 year is really affordable for class 8th and 9th standard students, because you will be going, the 8th standard students will be going for the 9th, 9th will be going for the 10th standard. So you will be able to get access to various courses. The batch courses of class 8th and 9th and 10th is separate, and the 10th board exam, the crash course will be different, and also various competitive exams courses will be different, and foundation for NEET and JEE will be different. So take the subscription as soon as possible by using the code VRLIVE. So write VRLIVE and click on apply to avail 10% discount. So this will be the final price. So let's quickly begin. Yes, this is the code. So let's quickly begin the revision session, the quick revision session on the live process. in the form of flowchart, in the form of table. I know many of the students, you feel life process is a huge chapter. But at the same time, it is very, very, very easy chapter because you are learning about yourself. What is life process? Essential requirements, essential functions that happens in the body in order to show the growth and development. Right? So you are learning about yourself. You should be healthy because you have got a lot of exams to write. So in order to be healthy, you have to know which are the life processes. How to carry these life processes and how this happens in your body. Okay? Yes. So, in the very beginning, we will be studying about, I have made a flow chart on nutrition, mode of nutrition, the different mode of nutrition. Nutrition is an essential life process, right? So, if you want to study well for your exam, you have to have enough amount of food. You have to have enough nutrition. So there are mainly two modes of nutrition, that is heterotrophic and autotrophic. So the whole process by which an organism obtains food is nutrition. So nutrition in plants will be autotrophic, autotrophs. Plants are autotrophs. It means can make their own food, whereas nutrition in animals is heterotrophs. Depends on plants or other animals for their food. So what is this heterotrophic mode of nutrition and autotrophic mode of nutrition? Yes, of course, you know this. This would be the flow chart which will be helping you to revise, right? So autotrophic means, so kinds of nutrition in which inorganic molecules, inorganic and organic materials like carbon dioxide, water, etc. are utilized to prepare organic food by the process of photosynthesis. Okay, so this is specifically photo autotrophic mode of nutrition. So also, if you want to study for your various competitive exam, I can tell you under autotrophic mode of nutrition, there is again two types: chemoautotrophic and photoautotrophic mode of nutrition. Chemo is using chemical in order to produce own food. Organisms use chemicals to produce its own food. Whereas photoautotrophic mode of nutrition, in which organisms use light to produce its own food. Okay. So, in general, autotrophic mode of nutrition is in which organisms use inorganic molecules like carbon dioxide, water or light or some other chemicals as well. Anything they can use to make their own food. That is the general name of, that is the general definition of autotrophic mode of nutrition. You can give examples. Some of the bacteria, photosynthetic bacteria, all the green plants, they will be able to carry autotrophic mode of nutrition. Coming to heterotrophic. Auto meaning own. Hetero meaning different. Hetero meaning different. Right? Hetero. Logos, homologous, homogeneous, heterogeneous. You might have studied in chemistry as well. So, heterotrophic mode of nutrition is the type of nutrition in which, kinds of nutrition, in which organisms do not possess the ability to synthesize their own food. Instead, they will be depending on other organisms, different organisms, right? They depend on autotrophs for their food supply directly or indirectly. Okay. So again, if you are studying for any entrance exams or competitive exam, you can also show the division of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. It can be parasitic, saprophytic, saprotrophs, symbiotic, holozoic mode of nutrition. So there are different types of heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Even insectivorous is a type of heterotrophic mode of nutrition, right? So examples, animals, fungi, some of the protists, they are able to show heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Okay, so I hope you have understood very easy. This is the very easiest concept in the life process. Now coming to quite difficult. I am not telling it is difficult because it is your perception, because digestion, your understanding how the nutrition is going into your stomach and other part of the body to gain energy. So even students find quite difficult to understand the process of digestion and understand and remember the process of digestion. But you have to imagine, in order to remember this particular flow chart, before learning this flow chart and writing this flow chart, you have to imagine how the food is digested in the various part of the body. When you eat the food, when you eat, let's say, roti, what you do? You start chewing, right? So what is this? What is this chewing? It's the mechanical digestion that happens in the mouth, which will be involving chewing, grinding, rolling. These all will be involving under, it comes under mechanical digestion, which involves teeth and tongue. How many teeth we have got? 32. And you can write the dental formula here. 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, 2, 3. Totally 32. Right? You can write dental formula as well if you want. Then, we have seen what are the things that should happen in the mechanical digestion. Teeth and tongue is involved. We will be grinding, chewing, rolling the food. Right? To produce the food bolus. The food after showing the digestion in the mouth, the food is called as bolus. But not only the mechanical digestion, even the chemical digestion should happen. The salivary gland will be producing an enzyme, salivary amylase. The carbohydrate digesting enzyme, salivary amylase, will be acting on the starch to produce dextrose and oligosaccharides. Right? Change starch into sugar. Salivary amylase will be changing the starch, will be converting the starch into sugar. Fine. So only carbohydrate digestion you will be able to see in the mouth. 3% of the digestion can be seen in the mouth. Now the food bolus will be going into esophagus, food pipe, not the windpipe. It has to go to the food pipe. The esophagus. So, esophagus will be taking the food from the mouth to the esophagus by peristaltic movement. Forward peristaltic movement. The rhythmatic contraction and relaxation of the muscles of the esophagus. Contraction and expansion of alimentary canal will be causing the movement of the food bolus into the stomach through the esophagus. Okay, now. What should happen in the stomach? Imagine you have eaten. Now you can feel the food going through the esophagus. Now it reaches your stomach. What happens in the stomach? Stomach has got acidic pH. Gastric juices like pepsin, HCl, mucus will be present in the stomach. Pepsin, the name itself says, it is a protein digesting enzyme. So, pepsin, it will be before produced as the pepsinogen, the zymogen form. So, pepsinogen need to be converted into pepsin. So, in order to convert into pepsin, they require acidic pH, gastric acid, HCl. So, once the pepsin is produced with the help of gastric acid, HCl, and the gastric pH, the acidic pH, the pepsin will be breaking down proteins to produce peptone, proteoses, right? So this protein, the broke down part of the protein, will be then going into the intestine. You may get doubt, ma'am, how can we have acid in our stomach? We have got one more protective inner lining of the stomach called as mucus, which will be protecting, the stomach lining from the acidic pH of the gastric acid. Okay? And also, I have not mentioned about two hormones, gastrin. Gastrin will be activating the production of the gastric acid, whereas somatostatin will be inhibiting the If there is excess production of gastric acid, somatostatin will be inhibiting. Okay, that is not being mentioned in your NCRT. That is for your information. Fine. Okay, now the food has gone to small intestine. Correct? I hope you know the digestive system. You will be, when I'm telling all these, you should be able to imagine from the stomach. It has to go through the intestine. But also you can see the structures of the liver and pancreas. Liver with the gallbladder, a small pipe connecting to the intestine. And also the pancreas, the small pipe of this small tube-like structure of these pancreas is connecting to the intestine. So secretions from the liver as well as pancreas need to go into the intestine, right? Yes. So liver will be able to secrete bile, in the sense they will be producing the bile. Liver will be producing the bile, but these bile juice, bile salts will be stored in the gallbladder, whereas pancreas will be able to secrete pancreatic juice which can have pancreatic amylase and lipase, okay? And intestinal enzymes will be able to digest all the three molecules like proteins, fats and carbohydrate. So all biomolecules will be digested and absorbed in the small intestine. So pancreatic juice, which will be secreted from the pancreas, will be going into the intestine. So these pancreatic juice will be having trypsin and lipase. So this trypsin, which has been produced from the pancreas, will be going into the intestine, and in intestine they will be converting proteins like peptones, proteoses, which are produced in the stomach, will be then digested by trypsin to produce peptides. So peptides are made up of amino acid. Okay, so the smallest unit of proteins are finally produced in the small intestine. Same way, coming to the lipase, the pancreatic lipase, which is being produced from the pancreas, will be able to act on the fat to convert it into fatty acids and glycerols. This is again the smallest unit of lipids. Okay? And also pancreatic amylase can act on the carbohydrate to produce the smallest, not exactly a smallest form, but the disaccharide form. And the disaccharides which are produced in the small intestine, like maltose, sucrose, lactose, these all are the disaccharides which are finally produced in the intestine, will be digested by intestinal juices like sucrase, maltase, lactase. These all enzymes will be acting on sucrose, maltose and lactose to produce monosaccharides like glucose, fructose and galactose. Okay, so this process happens in the small intestine. And the bile which is being secreted from the liver also has to come to the small intestine, will be able to digest the large fat globules into the small fat globules through the process called as emulsification. So you can see here, all the digestion, all the different types of digestion and maximum digestion and maximum absorption happens in the small intestine. Okay, whereas the large intestine will be able to absorb the water, and then the waste that has been collected from the intestine will be temporarily collected in the rectum, and finally through the anus the waste will be excreted out, ejection. So assimilation is the absorption, digestion, you know, breaking down of the molecule, and ejection is the excretion. So very simple, you should be able to visualize. Mouth, carbohydrate digestion. Stomach, protein digestion. Whereas intestine, all the three type of biomolecules will be able to get digested with the help of secretion of liver as well as with the help of secretion of pancreas. Pancreas will be able to have pancreatic amylase, lipase and trypsin. This all three things are from the pancreas. And liver will be able to produce the secretion like bile in order to carry the emulsification process. Okay, maximum digestion absorption in the small intestine, absorption of water in the large intestine, and collection of the waste in the rectum, removal is through anus. Okay, so this is about the digestion, very easy. Now, quickly coming to the respiration. Why we have to eat food and why we have to respire, why we have to intake the oxygen. So, in the next class, I'll be talking about the breathing, respiration in detail as well. Okay. So, why we have to respire, why we have to intake oxygen and why we have to take the food? Ultimately, to produce ATP. Correct? So, the food that has been taken in after digestion in the small intestine, I have told you, the carbohydrate finally will be able to produce the smallest unit called as glucose. So this glucose will be oxidized with the help of oxygen. And in some organisms and in our cells, in our own muscle cells, if you consider, because of the insufficiency of oxygen, we will be able to show anaerobic respiration as well. So glucose will be undergoing glycolytic pathway, the process called as glycolysis, to break down the glucose into the pyruvic acid, the pyruvate. Pyruvic acid is also called as pyruvate. Right? So this process called as glycolysis, conversion of or breaking down of the glucose into pyruvic acid or pyruvate, which will be happening in the cytoplasm of the cell. And the process is called as glycolysis, and this is a common process that will be happening both in the anaerobes as well as aerobes. So both organisms which are able to show aerobic respiration, that which require oxygen and that which do not require oxygen, we will be able to see a common process, glycolysis, in both of these organisms, both of these type of organisms. So once the pyruvate is being produced, once the pyruvate is being produced, if an organism uses or intakes oxygen, or I can tell you in the aerobes with the presence of oxygen, definitely they should have mitochondria. And in mitochondrial matrix, we will be able to see the complete oxidation of glucose. So you will be able to see here, carbon dioxide, water plus energy. So maximum energy is produced because of oxidation of the glucose, that is in the aerobes. Correct? We won't be able to see complete oxidation of the glucose in the anaerobes, one which do not intake oxygen or one do not require or use oxygen. Very less ATP is produced when compared to the aerobes. 32 to 38 ATP is produced here. In the aerobes, one which is using the oxygen, one which have mitochondria, because oxidation, or I can tell you, in the aerobic respiration, mitochondria is the essential organelle, right? So, coming to the anaerobes, yes, this you can see in the case of yeast. Fermentation, this process of production of ethanol by anaerobic respiration is called as fermentation, process of conversion of pyruvic acid into ethanol, carbon dioxide and energy, that you can see in the case of yeast. So they will be able to produce 2 ATP by complete breakdown of the glucose, right? So this is the case that you can see in the case of a normal aerobically respiring organisms. But because of insufficient oxygen, we will be able to see in the muscles lactic acid and energy, a small amount of energy, 2 ATP will be produced. So accumulation of lactic acid causes muscles fatigue, and it occurs after rigorous exercises, that is in the insufficiency of oxygen. So this happens in the aerobically respiring organisms, because of the insufficiency of the oxygen, we will be able to see this type of breakdown of the glucose and pyruvate to produce lactic acid and a small amount of energy. Okay, so this is a flow chart of a respiration, and in the coming classes we will be learning the different flow chart, that is different concepts in the form of flow chart or table. Okay, so that's all for today. What you have to do, like the video, more importantly share the video, subscribe to the channel, share the video. You will be able to download the PDF notes of all the classes. Okay, and don't forget to click on the bell icon, and if you haven't subscribed right now, subscribe. Okay, yes, and you know about our other channels, Unacademy, Need, Unacademy, JE, and our own channel, Unacademy Foundation. And if you want to take the subscription, you can use my code VRLIVE to avail 10% discount. And I have already started the courses on various exams. And if you have got any request, you can ask me after taking the subscription. Let's crack all the exams. Let's crack it. And let's meet in the coming class. Bye-bye.